So since we've seen you, your earlier book, Deep Time, won a national award. That's a really good deal.
It did. It won the Epic Award as the best suspense thriller for 2017.
And that is not an easy genre.
It's not. And here's the thing. That occurred not long after I appeared with you and Alex on this show.
See?
So I think that started it.
We were good luck.
I give you a lot of credit for that.
Well, then there's no telling. This one could go Pulitzer. So tell us about No Return.
There's a lot at stake in No Return. There's a really bad guy who's trying to get control of the world economy.
Okay.
So now I take you to our hero, Jack Strider, who's a lawyer in San Francisco, public interest lawyer, good guy.
Mm-hmm. Trying to save the world in his own way.
He is, but he's already in bad trouble. He made an investment, $10 million that he didn't have, borrowed the money. The investment isn't working out the way he thought, so he's about to lose everything. Lose his law firm, lose the home where he and his law partner have been living, Deborah Vandenberg. So that puts him into contact with the bad guy in our story.
So that's how he discovers what's going on.
Yes.
And does he decide he's going to put on the white hat and take this guy on to save not just himself, but the whole...
Oh, no, it starts off a little more selfishly than that.
Okay. Well, at least you're honest about your protagonist.
Yes, but it does put him in contact with Cormac Slade, who is, some people who have read the book have thought, resembles the CEO of Goldman Sachs.
Oh, wow.
But in any event... Cormac Slade is the CEO of the largest investment banking firm in the world. But that's not enough for him.
He wants more
money. He wants more power.
So let me ask you this. Did this idea for this book, this concept, come to fruition in your head back in when? 2007, 2008? Yeah, okay. So
sure, absolutely.
And ripped from the headlines.
In my business life, I've done a fair amount of business with Wall Street.
Yeah.
I've known people like this. For whom enough is just never enough.
But writing about this world, you have to be accurate. And that's that's a world that unless you've worked in it, you know, you may get things wrong. How do you do your research?
Research is, because of my background in practicing law, research is one of my favorite. Mostly because I have a really strong sense of curiosity.
Mm.
So I do a lot of research. A lot of this comes from personal experiences. Many of the characters in this novel, in No Return, especially the women characters, are based on people I have known various times during my life.
Yeah. So this strikes me, and having read Deep Time, mm-hmm. I think the character needs to be on screen. Have you thought about who you would want to play Jack Strider? Be honest. I know you don't get a vote in that, but...
No, I haven't.
There's nobody that comes to mind, really?
But I do think of it in terms of a film.
Yeah, it's very
your
previous book was very cinematic.
Partly because, to me, settings are so important. And in this book, we start off in Inner Mongolia.
Mm-hmm.
Ultimately, we're soon in San Francisco, then Wall Street, and later on the Middle Fork of the Salmon River, which is also called the River of No Return. Because so many people die on it, and that's part of the origin of the title.
So, did you have to take like a research trip to these places?
Absolutely.
Is that one of the bonuses?
Well, as you know from our previous conversations, I've traveled quite a lot in the world, including Inner Mongolia. And in this case, on this Whitewater River, I've made that trip in the past.
Okay.
And I kept a lot of notes, and so it just flowed
from
that.
Well, Rob, here's what I'd do. I'd figure out where in the world I want to go and then set my next novel there so that you have an excuse to go tax deductible. So there you go.
It's
just
such a
little tip. I'll look forward to hearing what award you win.
And we're on the way because I'm here again.
Yeah, you've been back on Live at 9.
Thanks again,
you're a shoe-in. Thanks, good to see
it's
you.
A pleasure.